In the name of the motorsport of Gaildorf, and thank you for coming. My special welcome today will be to the international jury, representative for all members. Greetings to Mr. Magnussen from Sweden, the president of the FIM Motocross Commission, and the president of the international jury of this event, Mr. Hofruis from Netherlands, and the gentlemen of the OMK and ADSC. Many thanks for the confidence that we can organize the Motocross World Championship for national teams here in Gaildorf. With much pleasure, greetings to the guests of honor, sponsors and friends of our club, and the delegations of a lot of Motocross racing organizers of all countries. A hearty welcome to the ladies and gentlemen of television, broadcasting and press, the representatives of industry, also managers and riders. A lot of thanks to all who helped to organize this great event. Special thanks to all helpers who will give the best to have a very good race today. Much success and races without any accident for all riders. And for all visitors, exciting races here on the beautiful Wacht in Gaildorf.
Since 1981, American riders have wrapped up the motocross season with a trip to Europe for World Team Championship competition. And since 1981, the American teams have been the best. Four straight team titles in the 250cc event, the Trophy Donations, and four straight in the 500cc event, the Motocross Donations. 1985, however, was to have been a different story due to a brand new format. A single event consisting of three motos with 125s, 250s, and 500s all racing together.
Well, the new format is three riders per country riding each in a different class, a 125, a 250, and a 500. And the scoring is done individually in each class is scored individually. A rider could be, for example, in fourth place on a 125, and he still could score for first place for his class. And then they make the best, they take the best six results out of the nine heats.
Gaildorf Germany played host to the new event, and a huge crowd of European enthusiasts turned out for the festivities, including a large contingent of American supporters. They all came to see if the Americans could make it five in a row. As was expected, when the gate dropped at all three motos, the Big Boar 500 stormed to the front, followed by a mixture of 250s and 125s. In the first moto, Ron Lachine, number three, suffered a horrible start, but still managed to work his way up to 12th overall and third in the 125 class.
Gebackene Weltmeister aus der Königsklasse. Und dann dahinter diese Fahrer, ihre Maschinen beherrschen.
We are looking down low, and we see that Glenn Bell, the Australian driver, is in 20th place. Rob Anders is still there in 25th place for Great Britain. Ronnie Lachine is in 26th position, immediately behind Anders.
Leading the race, David Bailey of America in second place. Was in third position, but it's now Jeff Ward in third position. Third place goes Heinz Kinnegartner, then Kate van der Ven, Jackie Vermont, Jackie Martin, Roland Diepold, but the leader of the race, the world champion himself, David Thorpe of Great Britain.
Slip number 7, South for Billy. Four, Dan Kindergartner, Pankerfeld, Rinaldi, Martin, Solenak, William, Jesperson, Karim, Streubus, Dave Streubus, der Amerikaner vorne. Und als dritter dann die Startnummer 7.
Well, just to bring you up to date again, America moving in dramatically then. When both David Bailey and Jeff Ford pass the British world champion Dave Thorpe. But their third rider well down the field, that's Ronnie Lachine. We've seen him have two falls so far, and he's in 31st position at the moment. Rob Andrews, the second rider in the British team, is lying in 29th place at the moment. But Bailey and Ward heading off the rest of the world just at the moment in first and second places. Dave Thorpe in third position with Heinz Kinnegartner, Kate van der Ven and Jackie Martin following. Come on! Climbing.
Still, but Aber ein erbitterter Duell der
beiden Jungstars, den 16- und den 17-jährigen Ronald und dahinter aus der 8. Position Gerstan van Dorn. Und damit hat also auch die niederländische Mannschaft ihren zweiten Platz in der Gesamtwertung halten können. Roland Diefold zurückgefallen in die 9. Position.
Second place, Dave Bailey in third, Jeff Ward in fourth, but we're looking at the strength of the 125 coming through now, with Ronnie Lachine of America in sixth place, Dave Schreiber in seventh position, and those two having a terrific tussle as America and Holland consolidate. Gert-Jan van Doren is right behind them in eighth place, the German champion. It's Roland Diefold in ninth place, the runner-up in the 250 World Championship, Jackie Beaumont in place. And Rob Andrews, the second English driver at the moment, in 22nd place. And a bunch of riders in front of him to climb up the leaderboard still further. But David Thorpe still the leader. Case van der Ven in second place. Then the USA pairing of Dave Bailey and Jeff Ward in third and fourth position. With one lap to go, Dave van der Ven took the lead from Dave Thorpe over the jump right opposite the commentary point here. He went past Thorpe as if Thorpe were stationary. Case van der Ven being the first man to beat the world champion since Thorpe became world champion. Case van der Ven then, the winner for Holland, Dave Thorpe in second place for Gaildorf. In third place was Jeff Ward. For America, fourth place David Bailey was Ronnie Lachine, so the Americans packing in fourth, fifth and sixth there. And to go with Thorpe's second place, he was Rob Andrews finished in 22nd position. So America packing in with Holland, and it's beginning to become a two-horse race. which they thought took the lead from the start. Michele Margaretto is in third place, Jeff Ward from America is in fourth place, Jukka Sintonen from Finland in fifth place, Roland Depot in sixth position. Looking down the field then, there's Youngquist, Fortenson, Leif Pearson, Ronnie Leachin, and we're looking at Dave Bailey, who's down in 13th place, but America can only improve on the score of 11 that they've made so far. It can't be any worse, so it's looking a little bit as if they're favourites.
Und auf den Spitzenpositionen scheint sich also der Kampf zwischen den Top und Keith van der Been, der Niederländer, führt das Feld nach dem Orange Trikot an. Die Startnummer 10, 9, der neue Spitzenreiter, Keith Top aus England. Und auch Jeff Barth versucht jetzt an die Gele Margarotto vorbeizukommen. Jeff Barth in der vierten Position. Fünfter, der Jukka Sintonen.
Dave Thorpe then still late from Case Van der Ven. Thorpe finding the way over the jump opposite to the commentary point here in a much better way in this third and final leg. Opening a gap now from Van der Ven. Jeff Ward in third position. Michele Margaretto for Italy in fourth place. Fifth place is Roland Diepold of Germany. Sixth place, Ronnie Leachin of USA, followed by Jukka Sintonen and Kurt Youngquist with David Bailey behind him. We're watching the progress of Rob Andrews, who is in 21st position just off our leaderboard, but looking good to give England a result at the end of the day. Now he's climbed up into sixth place, but remember he started on the second row and he's already up into sixth position. Dave Thorpe, the race leader for Great Britain, Case Van der Ven, is still there in second place, but good news for Great Britain in that their second rider is now up into 18th place on the 125cc Kawasaki, which is placing so far in the racing. Jeff Ward though is there in third position, Michele Margaretto for Italy in fourth place. Fifth is Ronnie Leachin and sixth is David Bailey. So Great Britain in touch with six placings from six rides so far and keeping their fingers and their toes crossed for a good final position. But the race leader then, Dave Thorpe of Great Britain, with Case Van der Ven of Holland in second place. Thank you.
Sie erkennen also weiße Buchstaben und 250.
Thank you.
Three motos and three classes all mixed together, scoring and keeping track of team points was a nightmare. Regardless, when the last checkered flag was thrown, the U.S. team came out on top. Stiff competition came from runner-up Holland, with a host team, West Germany, finishing third. The new format was heralded by all as a huge success. Hopefully, in 1987, the motocross donations will be held in the United States. And hopefully, the United States team will make it seven in a row.
Und nun darf ich nach vorne bitten. Sensationell.